welcome back once again to Discussion-Based Teaching Explained, a channel dedicated to discussion-based classrooms on which I hope to explore how to teach and learn in a discussion-based environment. This is another special episode with the student's voice, and this one is dedicated to writing in a discussion-based classroom. For this series, I asked two former students, Jamie and Emily, to interview a bunch of other former students about a lot of different elements of their experience in a discussion-based classroom. And then the next five episodes of Discussion-Based Teaching Explained are going to talk about writing in a discussion-based classroom. So this special episode of Discussion-Based Teaching, the students' voices are going to kind of preview those writing-based episodes. Here we go. We're going to start out with Jared, Drew, and Elizabeth just talking about the interplay between writing and discussing.
That writing made me a better writer, but also made me a better discussant, because I didn't have to specifically try to talk in an elegant manner like I was, you know, a 50-year-old college professor. I could really share my own opinions and speak what I thought could contribute to the discussion. Yeah.
During and after the discussion. So at all these times, writing everything down allowed me to like process everything that came in and kind of write my own take on it, but also just process what was going on more. Instead of just speaking without thinking, I could have my ideas already kind of knew what I thought about the certain topic. And especially writing at the end, you could think back on the conversation and just reflect more on the overall conversation. So I thought writing in general just allowed you to get a deeper experience out of the discussion.
And then there's also like journaling to get ready for a discussion. And I would say that's also really important, because if you try to go into a discussion either having not read the material or not thought about it, then it's just not going to be as rich.
In this next segment, Charlie, Ellen, Jared, Drew, and Elizabeth all talk about how instrumental and important writing is at the beginning of the discussion.
It helped jumpstart so many discussions by just writing at the beginning, and then everyone had something to share, because it's not like people are able to say, oh, I don't know what to talk about or different things. But if everyone has to do a writing, then no one can opt out, and I think it helps push different people
in a spot. And if we ever felt like the direction we took was kind of like leading nowhere, we could say, okay, well, remember at the beginning, like this person read aloud that they wrote about this idea that they found interesting. Like, let's go back to that and unpack that a little bit more. So I think the writing in the discussion was huge, just because it like created our foundation.
Whatever class or break I've come from, I'm not really focused in yet. So having that time at the beginning just allows me to like settle into the class and just write whatever I'm feeling that at that moment, and just like just let it get settled and then get ready to just start class.
We started every class with a free write, and it was not about class. It was about whatever you wanted. The only rule was that your pencil had to like keep moving for, I don't know, like 5 minutes. Mm-hmm. And the whole point was actually, it was like, everyone would like come in pretty rowdy, and then it like this would just like calm everyone down.
Yeah, I like the free writes. One reason I did was because a lot of times you're moving around quickly from different classes, and it's just a moment to kind of relax and like catch your breath, and just kind of spill your thoughts, like if you had a stressful day or whatever, on paper. Times we had a focus free write. And I personally enjoy the just regular free writes better than the focused free writes, but it's all nice to mix it up.
Listen as Alex, Frankie, and KB talk about writing as like self-care. I love that idea. And really how the writing kind of honors their own ideas and their personal experiences.
But just being able to write for however long, like 1 minute, 3 minutes, 5 minutes type of thing, like it was really nice just to be able to settle in and be alone with my thoughts. Really felt like an act of self-care, at least over time.
I was like encouraged to go deeper, I guess, and to involve like myself. Like in past years, you know, we would write about the book or that we were reading or, you know, something like that. And there wasn't like a lot of room to get personal, but with like the reflection papers that Reader Moon would have us write, like I found myself getting like really personal a lot, and helped me like to then feel comfortable being like vulnerable and having that sort of vulnerability in my discussions.
Through the personal reflections, I was able to find a more personal form of writing, and just to be able to kind of understand my thoughts. And so because I was able to understand my thoughts in writing, it made me become more aware in discussions and put my own opinions and my personal knowledge into the discussions. If I didn't learn or internalize what I took from my writings, I don't know if I would have been as an effective of a discussant.
I think Jo makes a really great point here, especially for people like herself who talk very easily, that writing really helped her kind of hone her ideas.
Writing really impacted my discussion, because it's like when you write something down, you really have to think about it, instead of like when you're just talking, it's just like whatever comes to your mind, like you think about it for a second and mm-hmm. say it. So like with writing and discussions, like it kind of helped my vocabulary even when I started doing discussions by like writing things out and then doing those reflection papers. Then I can take from what I said in my reflection paper, which was really good, and then use mm-hmm. it in the discussion, which made me a better discussant. I'm sorry. Yeah.
Since Mr. Ruderman really emphasized speaking verbatim, that really helped for me, because it sort of forced me to actually say what I was writing, and that helped my ideas come across a little bit more coherently.
And Wade really kind of captures here the kind of symbiotic nature of writing and discussing.
And so it definitely crossed over into discussions a lot. Like I would have an interesting discussion and then go home and write about it in my paper, and kind of vice versa. So I think it really like crosses over between, like the discussion is sort of the paper and the paper is the discussion too. And so the line is kind of blurred between like your own ideas and other people's, which I think is really cool.
Well, there you have it, kind of a little insight into the role that writing played in the students' experience in a discussion-based classroom. Kind of, I guess, a little exploration of how writing and thinking and discussing all work together. So as I said, this special episode will kind of tee up the next few episodes, which really talk about journaling and writing in the discussion-based classroom and how important it is, foundational even. Special shout out in this episode to Emily Chen and Jamie Brennan for tireless hours of more than 25 hours of interviewing, and for all the awesome discussants who gave generously of their time and like really thoughtfully reflecting on their experience in discussion-based classroom. So thanks again for tuning in to Discussion-Based Teaching Explained. I'm Adam. If you have any comments, please leave them below or email me at discussionbasedteaching@gmail.com. Thanks for watching.